Righto, now the Dell XPS 15, the legendary XPS 15, my most recommended laptop. Look here, 9560, got over 26 videos on that. If you include the previous model, the 9550, I've got over like 56 videos on it. This is my favorite laptop without a doubt. It is the undisputed king of 15-inch workstation sort of content creation, ultrabook premium devices. It has that segment sewn up as the king, okay? It's better than the MacBook Pro, the ZenBook Come. It promised a lot, but it didn't deliver. This is still the king. Now, there's supposed to be an update for the XPS 15, whether it's called the 9570 or whether it's just a CPU and GPU refresh. We'll have to wait and see. But I'm very interested in this. I'm pretty sure you're interested in this or you wouldn't be watching this video. So what do we know? We've heard some leaks. Now, I think eventually the XPS 15 will end up looking like the new Arctic White 13-inch XPS 13, which I have a video about. I'll leave the link in the description to that. I'll also leave a link in the description to my recommended model for the current 9560 XPS 15. Now, what they're saying here with this rumor, some bloke apparently saw on the Canadian website, like a leaked web page that's been taken down now, about the new XPS 15. Now, whether it's true or not, I have no idea, but let's speculate anyway. The leak apparently suggests it has a GTX 1060 or the option of that, whether it's Max-Q or not, or it's a somehow throttled design, because put a 1060 in the XPS 15, well, I don't know about that. It's no one has put a 1060 in a laptop this small without being deafened by fans or running hot, so maybe it's Max-Q, who knows. It's supposed to have 8th generation CPUs, so maybe 6 core, Kaby Lake R or Coffee Lake CPUs. Hopefully it's not the 8th generation quad core going in the XPS 13. I doubt it will be. Hopefully it's a 6 core. That'll be fantastic. It's supposed to have one more USB-C or one more Thunderbolt 3. So if this is a totally new design, maybe it's two Thunderbolt 3s and they have a new motherboard. If it's just the refresh, we'll probably have the same motherboard and they've just configured a new USB-C on it. But again, this is just speculation. Also, apparently it has a QHD touchscreen version and a 5K option. Now this sounds strange. Doesn't smell quite right to me. Even the 1060 doesn't sound quite right, but I'm happy to be proved wrong here. If it is, fantastic. This will be awesome. So it's going to have a full HD, a QHD, and a 5K option as well. So that'll be awesome as long as they keep a big battery in it and these new displays don't suck as much juice as the current 4K one. Now they also say Canadian $3,800. I have no idea what that means. If that's 2,000 American or 2,500, probably like Australian money, I'll guess. So I guess, yeah, that'll be the top model, 3,800 probably. And it's supposed to be maybe released in Q1. So people are saying refresh should occur in January. Who are these people? I don't know who they are, what their credibility is like. But anyway, this is what it is. Let me know in the comments what you think. Let me know what you'd like to see in the next XPS 15. The current one is still the king, so I wouldn't stop buying that. If you can pick that up, and I guess if Dell are bringing out a new model, there might be some deals to be had, or even if you can pick up one, dare I say, secondhand. Yeah, they're fantastic. You can replace the battery in them, upgrade them. They are just the best laptops still. So I wouldn't have no hesitations buying the current one now. Although, if there is a GTX 1060 in it, imagine the gaming possibilities. It sounds a bit strange because it sort of would eat into Alienware's territory there. I guess the displays will not be as good as the Alienware's in terms of gaming. I mean, for content creation, they'll be better. But for gaming, the Alienware's have better displays, the higher refresh rates and so on. So maybe it wouldn't affect the Alienware products at all. But if these rumors are to be true, I can't wait. And make sure you subscribe because I'll be covering this and 13 for that matter. So make sure you subscribe because I will do the most content on it and I will do the most comprehensive videos on it. Definitely subscribe. And just let me know in the comments what you guys think. I'd like to really thank you for watching. And until next time, guys, tally ho.